The Philippine Central Bank is confident the country's current monetary policy stance can hold over the next few quarters. It adds the economy has passed the most difficult period and is now on rebound. It also assures the public rural banks are adequately capitalized to absorb the impact of COVID-19, but consolidation is still encouraged.
The most recent one that we've done, by the way, is that we reduced by 1 percentage point or 100 basis points the reserve requirement for 3 in rural banks. That is a big help for them because, as you know, they are the biggest lender to micro, small, and medium enterprises. And that 1 percentage point or 100 basis points cut translating to 10 billion additional resources going to 3 and rural banks.
With us now for more is Elizabeth Carlos Timbol, president of the Rural Bankers Association of the Philippines. Hi, Elizabeth. Good morning.
Good morning, Michelle.
Great to have
you
on the
show. Thank you for inviting me.
Great to have you on the show, ma'am. So is there enough money to lend out? And more importantly, enough confidence among rural banks to do just that?
Oh, yes. With consolidated total resources of almost 250 billion, which flowed back directly to the countryside, making the rural banks champion of the government trust in promoting financial inclusion. In fact, with the additional lowering of 1% by the BSP, we can lend more. That's freeing us more of more or less of 1.8 billion. And that will translate to more than 100,000 borrowers again that we can lend out to the fisher folks, farmers, the MSMEs, the OFWs, and that with the partnering with the SBGC and the Philippine Guarantee, we will have more confident in lending to these sectors so that we can help the economy bounce back to recovery. Mm-hmm.
Because Elizabeth, here in Manila, the conversation we're having is that, you know, some are worried banks who are concerned about possible defaults might not be lending out the money. So are you saying that's not the case for rural banks?
Yes, as you know, Michelle, in fact, even during the quarantine period, we still continue to lend to our sectors. It is just that we are now more conservative and prudent because actually these are our sectors for a long time ago. And these are the sectors that we are the rural banks who know these sectors very well.
Mm-hmm. Elizabeth, you know, banks are about to live the stress tests that they've been practicing for years. And we know that no bank is really immune from record unemployment, lower interest rates. How bad is second quarter and the rest of the year's earnings going to be for rural banks?
You know, we have to say that we are affected in the first quarter because we applied the Bayanihan Act law, no? But now that that was lifted, our clients are now starting to pay back and go back to normal. And the main trust of the rural banks is not really to profit, but to uplift the lives of every Filipino and back, and to help the countryside development. So profit comes in second only. Mm-hmm. We are very resilient and we adopt changes easily with the support of BSP.
Mm-hmm. So, I understand that profit is only second when you look at the priorities of rural banks, but are you looking at a big hit in profits this year?
Oh, no. We're not really looking at that big hit, but more or less, at least we can still come up with a mirror to our profit. We're still positive.
Mm. Oh, still positive for this year. That's good to hear.
Yes, because we're very resilient. Mm-hmm. And you know what, Michelle, mm-hmm. I would like to add this, so especially for the rural banks in the central zone, we badly hit during the Mount Pinatubo eruption. And this is the worst that happened in the century. And you know what? We managed to bounce back. And you see where central zone is. Without the help of the rural banks, the central zone could have not bounced back that fast. And that is a concrete example, classic example, how rural banks really help in the countryside development. Mm-hmm. And in fact, Michelle, I would like to add, in fact, when we invited President GMA in our 65th anniversary last year, She said that when she used to be the president, she used to think that commercial as a backbone of the economy. And when she became a congressman, she realized that the true heroes in the countryside developments are the rural banks.
Well, rural banks are in many ways closer to the vulnerable and most unbanked segments of society. You mentioned this earlier. Your clients are the farmers, the fisher folks. You've got MSMEs out in far-flung areas. How are your clients doing? Are they transacting less? Are defaults on the rise? Talk to us about the behavioral changes you're seeing in your clients.
You know, yes, they were. Nobody was spared of them. Everybody's affected. But since we are more in adapted situations and resilient to these situations, our clients are more adapted to this one, especially the program of the administration now is plant, plant, plant. So these farmers will even boost their products as being they're given more help in the government. Mm-hmm. So there will be more inflow of circulations in the countryside.
Mm-hmm. Are you feeling more pressure now, Elizabeth, when it comes to capacity and capital as the government implements the Balik Probinsya program? That only means more people are going to be transacting with the rural banks.
We don't feel pressure. In fact, we support the Balikbayan program because it is with our MSMEs, the farmers and the fishermen, we can help stimulate the local economy to bounce back and recover faster. Mm-hmm. Especially if the 60 billion stimulus program that will be forced through the rural banks, the more that our clients and will spur the economy.
Mm-hmm. A lot of the big banks we talk to, you know, they're saying, yes, 2020 is bad. That's for commercial universal banks. But this isn't, they say, a balance sheet recession. If ever, it's just going to be an income statement recession at worst. Can the same be said for rural banks? Or are you already looking at perhaps smaller players who might go belly up and just close down?
Oh, no. As what the governor, BSP governor, joked, no. Said no rural banks will be closed down in this pandemic. No, as you could see, they have a better CAR and Kamas rating, and their NPL is good. And we would like to thank that over the years, the BSP has prepared us to enhance our risk management framework and has given us enough time to build up our capitalization over the years, so that we are ready to face any trials and crises that will come along, such as this COVID pandemic.
You mentioned how the governor said yesterday on our show that, you know, rural banks are very well capitalized. Talk to us about the NPL ratios on average that the rural banks have.
Okay, the average of the NPL since December and March, it's somewhere along 10.4 to 10.8%. But of course, with this pandemic times, it has a spike up to 60%. But we intend to recover by the year end because with the moratorium on past due, that the stimulus program that BSP is giving, we could manage. Mm-hmm. They are giving the stimulus program by BSP are very helpful to the RBIS.
Mm-hmm. And of course, you mentioned CAR. This is the capital adequacy ratio. The governor was so proud to say yesterday that your ratio is at 19.4%. That's much higher than the BSP's required 10% and the international standard of 8%. Pretty well capitalized rural banks that we have, huh?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Because this has been the program of the BSP for several years. It's like a build capitalization. Mm-hmm. So, and we complied with that over the years. And thanks to BSP for really pushing for that reform.
Mm-hmm. And are you seeing more, while you don't see rural banks closing down, are you seeing more consolidations? Perhaps big universal banks taking in small players to their network. We know that BDO last year bought a rural bank from Bulacan. 3 years earlier, BPI bought a stake in a microfinance bank, Rizal Bank. Are you seeing more consolidation among your members?
Well, I could see there would be more consolidations among us rural banks, no? But with the commercial banks before, I don't think so right now, because I think there will be a change or shifting of their priorities right now. I think there would be more of a conduit or partnership instead. Mm-hmm. Right now, instead of them branching branching, there would be more of a partnerships or conduit, making the rural banks as conduit.
And what about among rural banks, you know, smaller bank players getting together to form one big player?
There will be some few rural banks that will go on that, for few players that will consolidate, but amongst themselves.
I see. Are you seeing some specific plans for consolidation on that?
Not at the moment. There are around four or five of that, but it's still in the pipeline.
Okay. Are you seeing, Elizabeth, even among your nearly 3,300 members, a deliberate and massive shift to digitalization? Everybody's been moving to mobile banking, internet banking. Are your primary clients ready for this? Is the infrastructure ready in the countryside?
Oh, Michelle, that you will try to, you know, we started pivoting in digitalization. Mm-hmm. And in fact, the technology has connected all us together in what we call digital transformation. It is now seamless, CapEx-free, and quick deployment of digital payments. No? Collaboration is the key. In fact, we've already started the cash payouts of the South and the 4Ps by using of digitalization. Mm-hmm. And because of these collaborations with commercial banks and fintech gateways, mm-hmm. we are already in that.
Oh, wow. That's great to hear. But could you give us an idea how much of your clientele base were you able to move to the digital platform now? 30, 50%?
Right now is because first and foremost, as you mentioned, no, it's not actually the members. It's actually 3,271 banking units, mm-hmm. of the banks. No, so now they've come to realize that the rural bank has the widest network. So now, so for the commercial banks and the bigger banks, for them to be able to reach out to the bank sectors, they make use of conduits of the us rural banks, mm-hmm. and that's a. Like when they give out to the soft ameliorations and 4Ps, so basically it is being coursed through rural banks.
Okay, on that.
Hundreds of thousands of beneficiaries.
Okay, on that optimistic note, thank you very much, Elizabeth, for joining us this morning, and good luck to your group.
Yeah, thank you.